When did she escape?
Around 8 o'clock last night.
Her file. Read it to me, if you could.
Lambert, Hannah, born 1990. Angel Grove, California. Parents died in a house fire, no immediate family. She spent some time at Riverside Juvenile Detention Center before dropping off the map entirely.
What do you mean?
Well, the records for her are blank until she resurfaced a few months ago with an alias, Kirari. She broke into several corporate facilities before being apprehended and brought here. She believes some people are out to get her. I was working on a diagnosis, but honestly, I only scratched the surface.
Oh, you have no idea.
Is that it? I thought the feds wanted to interview everyone.
I think a special will take care of the rest. There's already an APB out for your car. And you said she had a friend who sent you Morse code through your phone? Well, I just ran a malware tracer and found an embedded signal. I'll see where it came from.
Hey, my throat still hurts a bit. What should I do if she comes back?
She's not coming back.
You need to be more careful, Kirari. I'm covering my tracks right now. All I need is another half hour.
Good, because Mendax isn't going to stop looking for us.
I know, but we have to take the fight to them.
I managed to decode some of the files you retrieved. I'm sending them your way.
Anything interesting?
Experiment logs for several subjects, schedules over the next week for some high-ranking board members, and some questionable financial statements. Looks like they've been sending payments to local law enforcement agencies. You might need to be careful about who you can trust.
Consider it noted. Thanks for getting me out of there, Kara. Listen, I'm almost done here, and I'll see you soon. We have to figure out our next move, and then...
Wait, someone's here.
Who?
Get on the ground, now. Hands behind your head.
Kara!
Let me guess.
If you do anything to her...
I don't respond well to threats.
You want me? You got me. Just let her go.
You've made some serious mistakes, Hannah. And the powers that be, they want you both. Preferably dead. It's just the nature of what we're in. You understand, don't you? No more running. It's time for you to come in.
Put her on the phone.
Sure. Maybe she can talk some sense into you.
Kirari, I'm sorry. I don't know how she found me.
I'm going to get you out of this, Kara. I just need a little time to think. Hold tight. I'll come for you.
It's okay. It was always going to come down to a moment like this. I wish we had more time. But I need you to promise me to keep going. When we started this, when I hired you, I suspected you were going to be a great employee. What I couldn't have anticipated was that you would be such a good friend. Don't let this change you. Don't waste your life.
If you hadn't found me, I'd already be dead.
That's hard to say.
Not really.
Everyone dies alone. But if you mean something to someone...
Kara!
I thought she'd never shut up.
Whoever you are, I'm going to kill you.
Oh, I doubt that. My name's Sonara, and I think we should meet. Don't you? Just come out from whatever rock you're hiding under. Hannah?
Are you there?
Come out and play. I'll gladly send you to wherever your friend is. How does that sound?
Like a dead woman talking. Wherever you go, you will never be safe. I'll find you.
I'm counting on it.
Have a seat. is a pretty nice place you have here.
You better not be wasting my time, Snell.
Trust me. We've got solid gold intel.
I'm Index Pharmaceuticals, or the mythical cabal known as Atlas.
You came all the way out here for a myth?
What do you got for me, Snell?
My colleague and I, we've been searching for leads on Mendex over the last few months. The sorcerer and his acolyte, Deborah Susan Cudendal, they've been ghosts up until now. A few detectives from Vegas Metro, they made contact with her. You still have the ear of the Attorney General?
I do. But if you're asking for authorization to bring charges against Mendex, you better have something more than just a ghost. We need actionable intelligence. If you can give me that, I'll walk you to the Attorney General's office myself.
You'll get it. I've got my best guys working on this.
All right, Turtle Dicks. Where is she?
Gone. Her office is cleared out. Files are gone. All the security footage is taken. Staff doesn't know anything. It's like she was a ghost.
So we're back to square one?
I gotta take this.
Well, that's new.
What do you got there?
Want one?
Valium. You take this every day?
10 milligrams. Keeps me on an even keel.
We need you sharp.
I'm as sharp as a dart, my man.
I'm not your man, pal.
I'm not your pal, buddy.
I'm not your bud, friend.
I'm not your friend, guy.
Officer Terrence. There's been a murder. 6676 Spring Valley Parkway. He said he needs us.
Spring Valley? It's all the way across town. What is he missed there for?
Can't say.
Wait. I know that address.
Buckle up.
No, really, you guys need to buckle up. That's a Category A recommendation.
Yourself?
Neighbors heard a gunshot. The victim was already deceased when officers arrived. We haven't been able to ID her. It seemed like a break-in gone bad until I found this. I was hoping you two would be able to figure out who Jane Doe is.
Looks like you have luck. I don't know who she is.
She was a hacker. You knew her?
Sort of. I met her once, but I never got her name.
Her name was Kara.
What the hell? How'd you get in here?
Lower your weapons. It's okay.
The hell it is. Who are you? Think you just waltzed into a crime scene?
She's our 100th arrest. We nabbed her a few days ago for a 1062. She's cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Her name's Kirare.
We heard you escaped. Still have a taste for the shadows, I see. Why don't you put your hands up slowly? Sunshine and I will drive you back to Ravencroft and get the help that you need.
I let you catch me last time. You won't be so lucky today.
Everyone calm down. Karari's helping me take down Mendex. She's an asset. And last time I checked, federal agents outrank local law enforcement.
Pulling rank again? Some things never change.
I'm older than you too, Sunshine.
You idiots. Both of you. I should have been here. I should have protected her, but instead you two had me committed. Like I was some sort of criminal. If you had just done your jobs, if you had just listened to me.
Hey, we're listening now. What happened here?
If I tell you, are you going to arrest me again?
No one's arresting you. Who did this to her?
They're after us. She rattled his cage.
Whose cage?
The sorcerer.
Aw, oh, come on. Not this BS again.
He's real. I've been trying to figure out who he is for months. Miss Bugendo works for him.
I still don't have a face to put to the name, but Kara uncovered some things about Mendex that could be damaging, if given to the right people.
Why are you guys going after a pharmaceutical company?
It's called Project Pegasus. It's in the encoded files I got for Kara. Strictly off the books, they're trying to develop new techniques to treat patients, but it's illegal and dangerous, and they know it. Not all of the trials worked, if any. That's why they're trying to cover their tracks. The program used unwilling participants. They had a type: addicts, homeless, or people involved in horrific accidents who are basically on their deathbeds without any family or friends. People like me.
You were a patient?
Part of the first trial.
What did they do to you?
It doesn't matter what they did to me. I was the sole survivor. That's why Kara was so adamant about helping me. She was the one person I could trust.
Then you can testify and bring this whole thing down.
Not exactly an ideal witness, which is why we got the files.
We got more files on Mendix? Whoever broke in wiped a lot of the stuff, but she's still got terabytes of info on the homeless population in town. We're working on sifting through it all and decoding it. Maybe we can pull our information together.
If I did have anything to share, it certainly wouldn't be with any of you.
Kurari, I think we've proven we're on the same side here.
Proven nothing. I don't know him, and the Mayhem twins locked me up. As for you, Mr. Gary, the fact that you're working with these clowns means that I don't know if I can trust you either. I'm sorry, Kara. I was never good at this sort of thing. Saying goodbye. Kara deserved better. Officers, take care of her, please.
We will. I promise.
We're not officers. We're detectives.
Then go act like it. I told you to find the Reaper before and watch over him. Do you think you can do your job this time? If you find anything, let me know.
Hey, where are you going?
Places to be, people to kill.
If this person was our only friend, shouldn't she be, like, grieving or something?
Just because you don't see it, doesn't mean she's not grieving. Terrence, how much longer until we decode the files?
We got a guy in the next room working on it. Come here, I'll show you.
You locked her up.
You saw how she was acting. She's clearly psychotic. Kurari, that's a poison, not a name.
It's an alias. She's got something you don't have.
What's that? A few screws loose?
Conviction? We're at war.
With the pharmaceutical company.
Mendex is in the process of being acquisitioned by a group called Atlas. And if that happens, then we'll be up against one of the most powerful corporations in the world. They've got virtually unlimited resources. Operatives around the globe, politicians working unknowingly at its behest.
Where are you gonna learn you can't save the world? Things are the way they are. You playing Billy Badass isn't gonna change that. How can you possibly hope to beat them?
Together. We need to take down Mendix and the Sorcerer before they become untouchable. Karari's a soldier. We're gonna need all the help we can get.
Is there a problem?
She's here.
Oh, good. Please, come in. Sit down. Is it over?
She escaped from Ravencroft before I got there.
Sinara, the only reason you are here is to take failure out of the equation.
I found her partner, the hacker. She's dead, and I retrieved the files she stole from you.
Well, that's progress.
What about the thief? She's still out there, and she put Deborah's associate in the hospital.
He's actually being released soon, but his voice hasn't completely returned. If she's as persistent as you say, then she'll find me. Te lo aseguro. But using a homeless man as bait might not be the smartest move.
It's our only play. The detectives went out of their way to help him before. They'll be looking for Reginald. And when they find him, we'll be there.
Sir, the hacker and thief I understand, but these other people, they're police officers. There's nothing in their profiles that would indicate.
You were brought in to do a job, Sinara. The reasoning does not concern you, are we clear?
Yes, sir.
If you do not ask questions about us, maybe we'll continue to make sure that no one asks questions about you. I don't want these cops coming anywhere near Deborah or me. If they do, you'll be of no further value to us.
No me hablas así. Sabes lo que puedo hacer.
I just hope you're properly motivated. Because as long as you do your job, we'll forget about the children's hospital. And you can go back to Atherton and visit your sister. Se llama Caitlin, ¿sí?
Don't you ever say her name again.
There she is. That's what I wanted to see. Now, what is the directive of your mission?
They all die.
He's right. They all die. You better get this done, Sinara. A lot of people are counting on you.
Agent Snow, how'd you meet with the senator go?
Inconclusive.
Any agreements contingent upon us actually finding incriminating evidence against Mendax. But Mr. Gary called me. He said that Mr. Dingle's office was cleared out.
Yeah, we were too late. Why don't we have a picture on file for her? Didn't you and Mr. Gary meet her once?
We did. That's before we realized how involved she was with Mendax and their operations. What are you working on?
One of my detectives sent me some files he retrieved from the home of the hacker. The person who stole information from Mendax. She was murdered this morning.
You're Ari's friend.
That's right.
You never should have sent her off to Ravencroft. She might have been able to help.
I know. It was against your recommendation, but you can never be too sure about the citations. It could be a serious danger to others or even themselves.
Fair enough. At least we know that she's working with us.
Hey, so do any of these guys look familiar to you? They're the only pictures I can pull up from that file. That file was coded pretty thoroughly.
Yeah, the one on the left is Joe Schlitz. We picked him up a few months ago. But he's been pretty much a dead end. He hasn't helped out at all. The one on the right, I've never seen him before. I think we might have a lead.
Body's on the way to the morgue. They said they could speed up the burial. Have her body ready later today.
Don't put it under her real name, in case Mendax is looking for anyone close to it.
So what's our next move, Pete?
I'm not sure. We need to find the Reaper. Can't believe you guys put him back out on the streets.
We got him on his feet. How many homeless people have you helped?
Without him, I don't know how we'll find Miss Prudendal. She'll lead us right to the sorcerer. There was some hired muscle I ran into a while back. He worked for Mendax.
Where's he now?
Prison. I put him there. It hasn't been helpful.
Maybe we can pay him a visit. I can be persuasive.
We found the name of Al Carousel. Grand Master.
He appears to be an errand boy with Mendax. Ping the cell. It's a few miles west of here at a coffee shop.
Alright. Let's go.
Thanks, Terrence. You think you can clean all this up for us?
Of course. Let's gear it up. You don't have to worry about me. Good luck with this guy. If you guys need anything, just let me know.
Connors.
Get past my security.
You should consider hiring some people who are more competent.
Are they dead?
No, they'll be fine. Maybe after some aspirin and a little physical therapy. Can't say the same about you, though.
You're Hannah, right? Hannah Lambert?
Curari.
An alias to hide behind, just like that mask. If you wear a mask long enough, sooner or later, you'll forget who you are beneath it.
This is where you say goodbye.
I am sorry about your friend.
What do you care?
I'm a humanitarian. I take it you don't know very much about me, do you?
Samantha Bennett, part of the Mendax Board of Executives. Your name came up in the files we stole, along with where I could find you. None of it available to the public, of course. I know there are others on the board, and I'll find them too.
I won't hold it against you. Plenty of people have tried to kill me.
Then I'll be the last.
You know, my father was there at the beginning of Mendax. I saw them start off with something pure, something exciting. They tried to make a difference in the world, to heal it. And for a while, they did. And it was beautiful. I tried to maintain that spirit, but then came the mistakes and the compromises. Some of my friends, they lost their way, started to use their positions for personal gain. And along came a spider, a man seemingly without a conscience, for whom the ends always seem to justify the means.
The sorcerer?
We create our own demons. If you know about him and me, then I'm sure you know about Project Pegasus.
Illegal human experimentation? Yeah, you think you're some sort of humanitarian? You're garbage who kills for profit.
A side effect of an ultimately altruistic goal, I assure you. And I meant what I said. I truly am sorry about your friend. The sorcerer, Mr. Roberto Reyes, and his assistant Deborah Susan Fudendo, they have too much power within our organization. With them in charge, all the good we've done might amount to nothing. The board has looked into Mr. Reyes' operation. Needless to say, the results have been mixed. Except for a few, like you. We still have so much to offer the world. I envision a brighter future where we can save millions.
Really?
Are you doubting our capabilities?
No, I'm doubting your motives. I'm sure you understand, but I don't trust you.
Nor should you, Miss Curare. Trust is overrated. Killing me won't help you. I'm a cog in a rather large machine. They'll replace me with someone just as powerful, but without my poise or philanthropic proclivities.
It'll make me feel better.
No, it won't. You look deep into your heart, you know I'm right. You're not a killer. But if you really want to be one, you should just find the people truly responsible for your friend's death. The sorcerer, Miss Pudendo.
Sonara.
Oh, of course. Sonara Smith, another one of the sorcerer's apprentices. I only met her once. But based on her history, she certainly has the skills, resourcefulness, and moral depravity needed for this line of work.
And now I have a face to a name.
Excellent. Then you can carry on with your little vendetta.
You want me to remove these people from your organization, don't you?
In a manner of speaking, we all have our roles to play. And when this is all over, maybe there will be a place for you. We certainly pay well.
Yeah, I don't think so.
You see yourself as some sort of righteous hero. But the truth here is that there's no heroes, no villains, just people trying to do their best. Most of those who've threatened me over the years, I now fondly call my colleagues. They've learned to put their determination and focus to better use and with far greater rewards.
Thanks for the offer, but you're talking to the wrong person.
We'll see.
Stan, listen to the Sunshine talk, man. About his voice, he just pisses me off.
Didn't you guys bump? His name Bump Bits? When you guys were younger?
Yeah. His bitch ass was on the bottom bunk all the time.
Well, I heard he used to wet his bed.
Yeah, he had a big bed wetting problem.
That's why he had to get the bottom.
He took, imipramine?
Think of that?
Uh-huh. Yeah, he was always wetting the bed at night, that nocturnal bedwetter. You know, sometimes I actually would just go down from my bunk and pee all over him while he was sleeping in his bed, and then he'd wake up and you'd think that he wet the bed.
Yeah. That's good. Yeah. That's good. Well, he told me that you used to get crabs all the time. I mean, that's what he told me.
I got a crab there. You know, well, for a while there, I was growing a little crab farm. I just thought it'd be kind of cool to have a little.
Is that what they call them out in Peru?
Yeah.
Crab farms?
Crab farms.
Ah, I gotcha. All right. So I know how you roll now. That's cool.
Well, it's just, you know, it's kind of like an ant farm, like some kids have ant farms.
Oh, I
was one of the first kids in my class to get pubic hair. So I was one of the first kids to go to get crabs. And it was kind of like, at the time, it was pretty cool. Like everyone else was like,
oh, I want crabs. So I had like the biggest crab farm.
Traversing crabs.
Yeah, you gotta keep them. You gotta keep them confined just to the pubic area. That's to get that, out of hand.
That's what they say.
Yeah, my girlfriend likes to pick them out of my hair.
Is it? Is that
like, the bug swarming in?
Is that a delicacy?
You know, in Oregon it is.
Yeah. But it has to be direct though.
Yeah.
Like not, it can't be transferred. It can't be transferred from like to the plate. It has to come directly from. Iron loose is something if you plate it and you present it.
Sunshine never tell you about his Velcro gloves.
Yeah. What's up with that?
Well, see, we grew up on a sheep farm, and you know, the sheep put Velcro gloves on them and can't get away.
Okay. Well, because you're about to shave them for their wool.
Yeah, I wish that's what he was doing.
Okay. Are you trying to beat them or clean them? Trying to clean them.
He's trying to clean part of them, I guess.
He's heading out.
Let's follow. See if he leads us to the regiment. Sunshine, where are you at?
I just ordered my coffee. You guys can manage this, right?
Typical Sunshine.
Vegas Metro. I didn't do nothing.
Then why are you running?
Here's a couple questions for you. I know my rights. Fascist. You work for Mendex Pharmaceuticals? Part-time. Just a delivery driver. Why?
What did you deliver recently?
When's the last time you made any deliveries, boy?
This morning, I dropped a home scout.
Was it the Reaper?
I don't know, man. I just know they needed him there.
What's the address?
That's all I got. Can I go? Get out of here. You and your fascist friends, you lost!
Hey. Punk-ass bitch.
We got what we wanted. The address he gave us, it's probably Reginald Vince. You stole the phone Ferrari gave you?
Yeah.
Give her a call. Address is 3800 Pecos Road.
What happened? Did you guys talk to him yet?
Yeah, we got him. Just a delivery boy.
What are you thinking?
We got Reginald into this mess. Least we could do is get him out of it.
She's not answering.
All right, Mikula. Come pick me up.
Let's go pick up your brother.
Hannah.
This is the third house I've broken into. Sorry about your lock.
What are you doing here? What's the matter?
Kara, she's dead.
I'm so sorry. How?
Murdered. And I couldn't save her. You want to ask me how I'm feeling, don't you?
How are you feeling?
Angry.
I'm worried about you, Hannah. You and Kara were like sisters.
She was the only person who saw me for what I really was. Did Kara ever tell you my diagnosis?
I believe it was schizoid personality disorder. Is that right?
I was bullied in school because I was different. So I pushed everyone away. I barely enjoy my own company, much less the company of others. No offense.
None taken.
I always lacked close friends. People to confide in, and I was completely fine with that. I would go into the fantasy world inside my head and be perfectly content. It was Kara that would pull me out. She was my only friend, and I refused to call her my friend. I wouldn't admit it to her or even to myself. When my family died and Mendax took me, when the experiments would get bad, I would go back to that fantasy world. And like so many times before, Kara pulled me out. If she hadn't gotten me out of there, I don't know what I would have become.
I remember what you were like then. Don't go back to that place.
It's too late, Reverend. I'm all alone, just like Kara was when she died.
I've spent so much time listening to people, trying to understand death. They try to find the connections, rationalize the decisions in their life, find out who they are. And what I found was the moment that often mattered the most, the moment when you truly found out who a person was often their last one.
Kara said to me that we all die alone. Those were her last words. I think there was more to it than that, but I can't remember.
Everyone dies alone. But if you meant something to someone, if you help someone or love someone, and if only a single person remembers you, then you never really die. I told her that. She used to come to the church every weekend, and she wanted you to come as well.
I know. I never did. Sorry.
If she had had more time, I think Kara would have liked to tell you something.
Let me guess. Go live my days in peace, find a cabin in the woods, and grow an herb garden or something?
No. You always thought there was something wrong with you because you don't feel things the way other people do. But she told me that that's what made you beautiful. She said that if you were a shape, you would be a straight line, like an arrow, unwavering.
Then you know what I'm going to have to do to stop these people.
Everyone has lost someone. You're not the only one, Hannah. To go out and kill people, that won't give you peace, and it certainly won't honor Kara.
Maybe not. But it will stop those people from hurting anyone else.
Some people deserve a second chance.
Oh, come on! For what? To hurt again? To kill again?
To try again.
Reverend, I feel lost. Like I'm falling and Kara's not here to pull me up out of the darkness.
She's here, inside of you. You just need to find her. She's the light that will help you through the darkness. If you continue on this path of vengeance, the darkness will swallow you. Listen to Kara. Find the strength in your love for her. Find the light within you and give yourself a second chance.
You two go through the front.
I'll take the back.
Thank you.
getting out of here. What happened to your foot?
Oh, my trench foot. It didn't bother me. So I went back to see my doc. She's a badass. She put me in a boot and let me stay here for a few days, get me off the street.
Your doc, Miss Pudendo, she's a fake. We gotta get you out of here. Can you walk?
Yeah, just give me a second.
We got Reginald. We're gonna be making our way to the side entrance.
I guess that makes sense. She was always a little off. You know, I did hear her on the phone today. Talk to a wizard or something? Something about a trap?
Reginald says this might be a trap. Keep your eyes open. Make an LZ and rendezvous in 2 minutes.
Where's the rendezvous?
This wasn't part of the plan, Detective. You were all supposed to be dead.
Well, why don't you just kill me then?
Oh, we will. But Miss Pudendal might have some questions for you. Who knows? You might actually do some good before you die.
Professionals, how can you let this happen?
We got separated.
Well, is he alive or is he dead?
I'm not sure. Pete needs medical attention. Send someone to the safe house.
Yeah, I'm on it. Need anything else, Sunshine?
Yeah. Backup, if you got it.
Sunshine, tell Karori where we are.
Cuckoo's Nest? Come on, bro. She can't help us.
Just do it.
I don't think we've met. My name's Reginald. sorry you got hurt.
Payne's an old friend. Marshal Peter Gary. Where's Miss Pudendal?
I don't know. She brought me there and she was treating me, but I don't know where she is. I'm sorry. I already told Sunshine and Makula. I don't know about this Mendex company you guys are interested in.
She didn't answer. I left a message.
He doesn't know anything about Miss Pudendal.
Did you grab the bag of meds she gave me? Then we got some. Next we need to focus on finding Makula.
We don't even know if he's still alive, Sunshine. An assassin were to cut through him like a hot knife with mashed potatoes.
It's because she's enhanced.
Miss Miranda is on her way. Are you comfortable, Detective?
Well, actually, I have a little bit of an itch on my ear.
Would you prefer I cut it off?
How about we don't? You could just tell all your friends you did.
Hands in front. Tie yourself. Ever try any drugs?
My body's a temple.
Been out of the country in the last 10 months?
Does Kansas count? No.
Ever had HIV, CMV, hepatitis, malaria, Chagas disease?
I have to check my childhood records, but I don't think so. What's this all about?
I lost a lot of blood thanks to your partner. So I'm taking yours.
You don't even know my blood type.
I'm AB positive, universal recipient.
You got a medical training for this?
I never made a convincing doctor, even when I was one. I'm more made out for this kind of work. None of it bothers me. I don't feel guilty or scared. I guess you could say I'm sort of isolated. Insulated. But you? You're just a normal guy with a normal life, aren't you? You have a family? Girlfriend? Wife? Wife. Other people I can go after if you don't cooperate with Miss Pudendal. Starting to worry about them, Detective? You should. You probably won't like what I can do to them. I can ruin their lives. Don't make me.
Were you always this insane?
Sonara, we really need to talk about the Miller case.
65-year-old Caucasian male, history of hypertension, instant placement, presented with acute chest pain.
I know the case, Dr. Smith. I'm aware of the measures you went through to save him, and I'm also aware of your interaction with the family. You walked into the waiting room with a Snickers bar in hand and proceeded to tell them that their father was dead.
He was?
You managed to revive Mr. Miller, so you saved him, which makes you somewhat of a hero. But his family is going to forever remember you as the doctor who told them the worst possible news anyone could receive while you casually ate a Snickers bar. I need to ask you, do you care if your patients live or die?
What kind of question is that?
Well, I mean, does it hurt? I've been watching you for some time, and it seems like it doesn't bother you.
This hospital's filled with doctors who don't care if their patients live or die.
No, this hospital is filled with doctors who pretend not to care, but you're different, aren't you? Your previous attendings have all said the same thing. You're technically proficient, remarkably calm under pressure, but they can't see what you really are.
Which is?
Well, you know the DSM-5 criteria backwards and forwards. And so my guess is you probably had yourself diagnosed in the first year, didn't you? So, what was it? Doctor?
Antisocial personality disorder.
Deceitful, indifferent, lack of empathy, arrogant, and inflated self-appraisal. Let me guess, conduct disorder in your youth? You should probably think about getting some cognitive and behavioral therapy, Sonara. Maybe some anti-epileptics as well. Most antisocials are in denial of their disease, aren't they? But you're the opposite. You know exactly what's wrong with you.
Of course I'm aware. I don't conform to social norms, laws. They don't apply to me. Aggressive, reckless disregard for others, lack of remorse. I ticked off more than 4 of the required categories necessary for a diagnosis.
It's a diagnosis that can be treated but not cured. And a diagnosis that means you really probably never should have been accepted into this program.
I watched them, the other doctors. I watched the fear and doubt creep into them. You think because I lack those feelings, that doesn't make me better? I watch them make mistakes again and again, and you're saying that you would rather have one of them work on you over me?
Yes, because if the only thing motivating you is becoming technically proficient, then one day you're going to get bored with this job. And that's going to be when a patient needs you the most. And that's really the difference between fixing and healing. You've got a brilliant mind, Sonara, and you're remarkably gifted, but the way I see it is you'll never be a doctor.
It's about time.
Only a delivery boy, huh? Fascist.
Where's Miss Pudendal?
Reoccupied. Here.
Sonara, you lost Reginald, and these detectives are still alive.
They were a little more formidable than I'd anticipated, but the detective I'm with knows where they took Reginald.
We're on a time crunch. Who do you have?
Hang on, let me check. Macula?
Smakula.
He's got a family, a wife and a kid. 112 River Hills Lane. Go pay them a visit. If he doesn't tell you anything, kill them all. Fail us again, Sonara, and we will bring someone in who is competent and can actually do the job. And your severance pay will be a body bag.
112 River Hills Lane.
Why are you going there? There's nothing you want there.
Where'd your partner take the Reaper?
You said you were a doctor. You're supposed to save people.
I'm much better at breaking things. ¿Entiendes? So what's it gonna be? Your partner? Or your family?
No. Please. Don't do this.
If I could feel sympathy for you, I would. But I don't. What I do feel is anger. I'm angry, Detective Makula. I'm angry that you have people you care about and yet you choose to sign their death warrants. You want me to play executioner? I'm more than happy to oblige.
Wait. 1812. White Feather Lane. That's our safe house.
Go check it out. You, stay and watch the detective.
Yes, ma'am. I gave what you wanted. Leave my family alone!
If you're lying to us, this isn't going to end well for them.
No. Please, no.
The vitals are a little elevated, but nothing to be too concerned about.
What about his meds?
He's a walking pharmacy.
I'll take a quick look at them.
I thought you said you were clean. That mom and dad were around.
No, I tore our family apart. You don't have to keep reminding me.
You're gonna kill yourself. Keep doing this.
I haven't ruled out that possibility.
Taranz, glad to see you.
Hey, Captain Ann called me. Got her as soon as I could. What's the situation?
I didn't know JCPenney was having a haircut sale.
Dr. Hedges says Reginald's doing okay, but Makula's missing.
Poor dad.
Detective Sunshine, these medications are not indicated for the condition that Reginald has.
What are they?
From what I can tell, he's been taking several anabolic steroids, an aromatase inhibitor, cimetidine, acyclovir, methamphetamine, and what appears to be a suspension of gorilla testosterone, peppermint oil, and papaya extract.
Mindex is experimentation.
It's ill-conceived and dangerous. This combination should have killed him.
That doesn't sound good.
I'll take these to the lab and have them examined.
Thanks, Dr. Hedges.
No problem. Good luck, guys.
So you're the one everyone's after. The Reaper?
It's a street name, ma'am.
Thought you'd be more imposing.
Listen, Reginald was a patient of Miss Pedendal.
Those encrypted files that you had didn't have much on them. Definitely not on a Miss Pedendal.
Then as of now, he's our best chance of taking down Mendex.
Sunshine, you already said he doesn't know anything.
That doesn't mean he can't be a witness against them. You remember what Miss Pudendo looked like, right?
This mine? Like a steel trap.
Guys, we've got company. We need to move.
How'd they find us?
Makula must have broken it. This place isn't safe anymore. We gotta get out of here, unless you want to end up like him and his family.
What about his family?
I'm trying to get it. It's been a rough day. Look, I need you to take a second and realize we're not safe here. We need to get out of here, okay? As soon as possible, right now.
I never mentioned anything about his family.
Go. Well, I guess this was inevitable.
What the hell is going on, Terrence?
Captain Dan refused to give me the location of the safe house until now. I guess in the back of his mind, he always suspected me. I told you I was a shark. Don't act surprised when I can smell blood in the water.
You work for Mendax?
I wouldn't say I'm a true believer. Let's just say I felt the wind changing and swung my sail. You really should too. You certainly pay well. And in your case, Sunshine, I don't think you have much of a choice.
You're out of your damn mind.
I guess death is the only alternative. It's a sad thing, you know.
I didn't want to come to this.
Despite your arrogance, I considered you a friend. Cool it too. Sunshine? It's me being honest.
No, Terrence. This is you being a psychopath.
Pudendo.
Good to see you again, Marshall. You're looking tall, dark, and deranged, just like I remember.
Perimeter is secured, sir.
Sir, you work for this cholo?
Mr. Gary, you have been a disruption in our plans for quite some time. I assume you always wanted to meet me.
The sorcerer.
In the flesh.
What do you want?
What belongs to me.
You took Reginald away from us, and we need him back. We're not done with him just yet.
I only see two detectives. Where's the thief?
I don't know.
All right, stop it. He's telling the truth. He doesn't know anything.
One of you knows, and I'll find out soon enough. Since we finally had the good fortune of meeting, I think you should know it's been a pleasure watching you work, but all games must come to an end.